Harrisburg, Pennsylvania is one of the oldest state capitals in America. This city, built on the banks of the Susquehanna River, has served as the state capital for over 200 years. A city that rose through its transportation and industrial might, it has experienced much change. This is What Happened to Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. Harrisburg, Pennsylvania was first settled in the early 1700s and had an important part in early American infrastructure. After its colonial era, it served as a valuable staging post in the westward migration of the eastern United States. Its location on the river, combined with the Pennsylvania Canal System and the Pennsylvania Railroad System, all helped the city grow and become a hub of economic activity in the region during the 1800s. In the latter half of the century, the city became an important military post for the Union Army, with the military camp Camp Curtin training many soldiers for the Civil War. During this era, it was also an important stop in the Underground Railroad. Like many cities in Pennsylvania, Harrisburg became a big player in iron and steel. In every decade from 1790 to 1910, the city grew at a rate of at least 27.4% and continued to grow until 1950, peaking at just over 89,500. The changes started long before the population declines, though, starting with the decline of canals at the end of the 1800s and into the early 1900s, with the Pennsylvania Canal closing in 1901. Then came the Rust Belt decline of the latter half of the 20th century. Steel and railroad activity would decline, with the rise of foreign competition in steel. The establishment of the interstate highway system would also take much passenger and freight volume off the rails as well. The declines in population would reflect this, as well as the large movement to the suburbs by many. As if there hadn't been enough industry decline in the city and region, in 1979, the infamous Three Mile Island nuclear incident occurred. This incident was just 3 miles away from Harrisburg. It would result in a partial reactor meltdown and partial closure of the plant, and would damage the industry's reputation in the United States. With the city already in a fragile situation, during this era, things would only get worse, with the election of Stephen R. Reed as mayor in 1981. For the next 28 years, Reed would preside over and be at fault for much of the city's further decline. As mayor, Reed believed in heavy investment in entertainment and tourism infrastructure. This would be done by the city taking on much debt. During his tenure, several hotels, museums, and a minor league ballpark would be built, with the hope of turning the city around. One of the most notable expenditures of this era was the $32 million National Museum of the American Civil War, which opened in 2001. This involved Reed spending the city's tax dollars to amass a collection of artifacts to fill the museum. However, while doing this, he also kept some of the artifacts for himself. Projects like this made other, more necessary projects, such as local infrastructure, fall into disrepair. Another failed project was a trash incinerator meant to serve as a power plant, only adding $300+ million in debt to the city. The city's debt would exceed well over $1 billion and would be indicted with securities fraud. Things would really hit their low in 2011 when the city would file for Chapter 9 bankruptcy, resulting in a deal that would bring the city out of debt via selling bonds, its incinerator, and the parking lease agreement. Stephen Reed would eventually be charged and convicted of receiving stolen property in 2015, but would serve no time in prison. The city would roughly bottom out at around 48,000 residents in the 2000s, and has had very mild increases since, along with improvements in its debt situation. Today, the city is supported through many state and federal government jobs, numbering around 50,000. It is also externally economically supported somewhat by nearby Hershey, PA, with its headquarters being there, and its amusement park being a destination location for many, receiving over 3 million visitors a year. Whether Harrisburg can recover depends on its ability to make the best of what it has in its local infrastructure and ability to improve over the past. It remains to be seen if this once prosperous state capital can recover. Thank you for watching.